over there, sitting on Lynn's,
Lynn's nephew, his oldest brother's youngest son. Also, I consider myself, Lynn is my favorite uncle, and I was his favorite nephew. It's nothing new. Today, as we gather to give our last respects to Lynn, I've always felt, you know, I was the favorite nephew, and I'd rather today not mourn his death, but let us celebrate the life that he spent here on earth. You can't mention Uncle Lynn unless you mention Barbara, his wife, who stayed by his side for over 50 years. It just shows that opposites do attract. And now together they can live eternity together and love. There was never a time we could not talk to Lynn. He would always give me advice, or give anyone advice, whether they needed it or not. Some of you may have known Uncle Lynn the way I did, but those who did not know him, this side of it, they missed out on knowing a great man. And he never wanted to be the center of attention. And if he was here right now, he would not want us to focus on the sadness of his death. Instead, at the people we still have in our lives, and he would want us to look at each other and appreciate what we have together and what we hope to make better. I have much consolation in my good feelings and my memories that he's given me. I still remember the first time I met Uncle Lynn when they came to Brooklyn from England, and everyone had English accents. Everyone had English accents except for Lynn. He still had his Trinidadian accent up there. He always had great stories and always made us smile. When he got his first new car, Plymouth Road King, you guys remember that, right? Plymouth Grand Coupe. It was the first time I took a ride cross country in Canada. I have all types of memories like that, which are really inappropriate for this podcast. he's passed us now, but I'm still here, and I have my family, and I couldn't tell you the stories of the things we've done. But they were all fun. And these are the memories that I take with me. Yeah, you know, for every day. We worked together for about 6 months for his older brother in Trinidad. We stayed in a small hotel where we made blocks one by one daily. And we would just travel up through the mountains and find a little path to find the Rasta man. Anywhere we went in the country, he could find the rest. looking back at this girl, that I always cherish, I will miss him dearly. But today, I will not mourn his death, but I will celebrate his life and his memories. And may he rest in peace eternally. Thank you.
Yeah, man.